Once you've identified a property that you'd like to make an offer on, you'll need one of two things: pre-approval from a lender, or proof of funds if you're paying cash. A few other things to consider when you're making an offer on a property is whether or not you'd like to have a home inspection. If it's a condo, you'll do a condo doc review and budget review. And if you are working with a lender, you'll be getting a mortgage contingency. All of these contingencies will protect your deposits, and it'll be my job to make sure that we stay within our contracted dates within these contingencies. Once I have drafted the offer and sent it to you, we'll go through DocuSign. You'll be able to open it and review it. If you have any questions, you'll obviously give me a call. Once we're ready to submit the offer, I'll send it to the listing agent. We usually give them 24 hours to decide. Depending on the situation, that could be shorter or longer, but we'll talk through that before it happens. Once the offer is submitted and the seller gets back to us, there's a few different things that could happen. The offer could be accepted if it's a stellar offer. We could get a counter. If there's multiple offers, we call that a call for offers, where the seller has asked for all offers to be at a certain time. We usually give the seller 24 hours to decide. Sometimes, depending on the situation, we might ask them to give us an answer in a couple of hours, and you and I will decide on what's best for you as the buyer. Once the offer is accepted, there's a few tasks you'll need to do. $1,000 offer deposit that will be cash and held in escrow. This is a part of your down payment and not an addition to. We'll need to choose a home inspector and schedule it, and we'll need to hire a real estate attorney. It's really important to me that, you know, the buyers that choose to work with me have a good experience, and so I have put together a team that I prefer all my buyers to work with. Obviously, you know, you're the driver in this situation, and I'm kind of just here as your GPS, hopefully guiding you in the right direction. So I have a lender that I prefer everybody to work with, and an attorney that's really important to me. And we'll kind of talk about each of those steps, you know, as we go, and why I think it's important that you work with the people that I work with. You know, they have my best interests at heart, and I have your best interests at heart.